Good morning, boys and girls. Happy Sabbath. I am out here enjoying this gorgeous fall morning, thinking of all the many reasons I love this season, like the spectacular view of all the vibrant colors of the leaves. It's the season for apple picking and pumpkin patch, pies and soups and hot apple cider. It's also the season for the geese to fly south for the winter, which brings me to my story for today. Last spring, a friend of mine got some unexpected visitors in her backyard. It was this family of geese. There was a mama goose and papa goose with their six adorable little goslings. This feathered family instantly fell in love with their new home. Their new home had a beautiful pond with a waterfall and a huge backyard surrounded by several acres of wetlands. As spring turned into summer, the little goslings grew into beautiful young geese, except for one. There was something different about this particular young goose. His feathers and wings were not the same like the rest of his family. In fact, his human family named him Scruffy because of his ruffled feathers. Although Scruffy looked different from the rest of his family accepted him completely. Scruffy did everything together with his family. He would go for a swim in the pond, laze around in the sun, or go for a stroll around the wetlands. However, there was one thing Scruffy couldn't do with his family. He couldn't fly. All summer, Scruffy tried very hard to learn to fly. He would run around and flap his wings wildly, but his wings were just not strong enough. No matter how hard he tried, Scruffy just couldn't fly. As summer turned into fall, we all dreaded the day when Scruffy's family would fly south for the winter without him. And sure enough, the day came when Scruffy's family flew away, leaving him behind. It was heartbreaking watching him run after them, flapping his wings wildly, crying out to them, but they were gone, and poor Scruffy was left behind. So Scruffy will be spending the winter with his kind and loving human family. Boys and girls, just like Scruffy, nobody wants to get left behind. But we live in a sinful world, and sometimes bad things happen. But cheer up! I come bearing wonderful news. There's a big, exciting trip coming up real soon, and everyone is invited. In fact, it's going to be the biggest, most exciting trip ever when Jesus comes to take us to heaven. Can you imagine how amazing that's going to be? Are you excited about going to heaven? Let's ask these kids.
So, why do you guys want to go to heaven?
I want to go to heaven because I can have a dog and I can fly.
I want to go to heaven because all those skies will be gone and I want Jesus to read stories to us and I want to pet a tiger.
Why do you guys want to go to heaven?
I want to go to heaven because of all the animals.
I want to go to heaven because we'll be happy all the time and there will be no more death.
I want to go to heaven because we'll finally be able to worship God forever and I can also get a pet cow.
And the reason I want to go to heaven is because there'll be streets of gold and then I can meet Jesus myself. And maybe I can pet a raccoon.
I can't wait to get to heaven and see all the wonderful things God has prepared for us. 1 Corinthians 2:9 says, "What no eye has seen, what no ear has heard, what no human mind has conceived, the things God has prepared for those who love Him." I can't imagine how beautiful heaven must be. If we love God with all our heart and sincerely seek to do His will, if we remain faithful and obedient to His word, He will take us on the biggest, most exciting adventure of our life. Boys and girls, this is one trip you do not want to miss or get left behind. So let's try harder than we ever did to prepare for that wonderful day. Let's be kind and love one another. Let's tell others about Jesus and His love. Let's share the good news with our family and friends and neighbors so no one gets left behind. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we know that Jesus is coming very soon to take us to heaven. I pray that you help every boy and girl be ready for that glorious day. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.